Hello and good morning, friends. Have you ever wondered what a septic system looks like on a house from the 1800s? Well, today I'm going to take you with me because we're working on a property that's actually being renovated. Now, this whole home is being gutted and stripped down to the studs and rebuilt to make it look amazing. But the county doesn't have anything on file and the builder needs to know where everything is and does it work. So I want to take you with me. So let's go ahead and see what we're working with and then we'll kind of figure out what's happening. We know we're off to a good start when the door is barely attached and the whole thing just comes right off. So let's go ahead and move this to the side, see if we can figure out what's going on in the basement and see where the sewer line is. All right, so we're in the basement area and the reason we want to be down here is to figure out where's the plumbing going so we can figure out where's the well, where's the septic, what does everything look like? So if we look over in this corner over here, we'll see that that's the actual sewer stack. So we know that the sewer's going out this way. So let's go ahead, walk around outside real quick and take a look and see what's going on. The reason why we wanted to come down here is whenever you have these old homes, a lot of times finding the septic system can be pretty difficult. So the easiest way to do that is you just see where the pipes are. And if we can't find anything easily accessible outside, we just pop open the lid, toss our camera through that has a locator, and then that'll help us find it. So we're gonna walk on that side of the property and hopefully it's easy. While I was walking around right next to our dumpster, we found the remnants of a lid. So I'm gonna grab my hook, pop open this plywood and this lid, and hopefully we find the tank. Now, we see all this gravel and all this trash. That's not super great, especially with the dumpster being right next to it. That's a lot of weight that we gotta worry about. Heat and septic tanks don't really play well together. So hopefully when we pop open the tank, we don't find any issues because, you know, dumpsters are heavy and the trucks that deliver dumpsters are also very heavy. The concern comes into play of potentially crushing the tank or causing damage, making it leak. So let's get the hook, open this up, see what we're working with and go from there. Alrighty, so we got the wooden plank off. We got that half of a riser lid off. And we can see that this is actually the tank. Now, she's a little bit further down than I expected. And the best part is you can see that steam rising up. May not come well off the camera, but sewage is hot. It's cold out, so it's gonna steam a little bit. So we gotta get our toe strap, pop that lid open and see what the inside of this tank looks like. Now, somewhere in this rock pile should be a cast iron clean out. And somewhere over yonder should be our absorption system. That's gonna be the harder part to find with all that junk laying around. But somewhere over here is where it should be discharging that wastewater. Generally in this area, most of these tanks will be concrete, 1500 gallons, and they'll usually have a riser. Now, depending on the size of the riser, composition of the riser, and condition of the riser can kind of give you an idea of roughly how old you expect the system to be. Now, this style of riser was generally used from the mid 50s all the way up until the 2000s. But it doesn't look too bad. So maybe we might be dealing with something from the 80s or 90s, not something from the 60s or 70s. Unfortunately, the county doesn't have any records. So we're kind of going into this blind, but we are here to help the builder figure out what on earth is on the property so they can continue their project. So while we're getting that lid off, the next thing we also need to do is get some water running. So none of the spigots are working on this property, which kind of sucks. But now what we need to do is we need to hook up a hose to the pressure tank so we can get some water into the system. And the reason we want to do some water through there is to make sure everything's flowing and draining the way it's supposed to. The term we use for this is called a hydraulic load test. Now, the hydraulic load is basically to see, is the system capable of functioning the way that it's designed to function? We have no records, so we don't know what the design spec is, but we can take a look at the actual house itself and we can see, all right, this looks like about a 2-bedroom house. So the system should be able to handle roughly 300 gallons of water per day, assuming. Because the home's been vacant and it's a complete gut rehab, we're gonna put the entire hydraulic load through to see what happens. Ideally, everything's flowing and functioning the way it's supposed to. What are some things that can pop up though? We could see a backup, we could see roots, we could see all sorts of problems that could cause the water not to flow correctly. And some of those problems you would only be able to see by running water because of how deep this system is. Okie dokie, so we got the lid off. A little bit of a pain in the butt just because it is deep. So you just have to pull it hand over hand to get that out. When we look inside, we can actually see that the water level is pretty low. We're about the halfway mark. Usually when a liquid level in a tank is at the halfway mark, it means the tank's leaking into mid-seam tank. So the next step, like we had previously a few days ago, is So we're gonna measure the solids, right? And then we're gonna ask the homeowner or the construction company, does anybody know when this tank was last pumped? Depending on what that answer is, kind of dictates what happens next. So for sake of argument, let's just say that we measure it, we see there's a good amount of solids, they haven't pumped it for years, the tank's leaking, right? Needs to be replaced. Key part with this particular property is there's a river maybe 300 foot away from the actual house itself. So in Maryland, if you're within 1,000 foot of a river, tidal water, bad soil, etc., you basically are going to be in the critical area. Generally, it's going to be if you're near tidal water, but those things can classify as critical areas too. So that means that you can't replace a tank with a conventional system. You have to go towards the advanced BAT systems. Those are best available technology. We've covered that previously. So if you have to go through this process of replacing the tank with an advanced treatment unit, that incurs an additional expense that most homeowners are not equipped for. Now, fortunately, we're lucky that this is not a primary residence. The homeowner already owns the property behind it. This is just part of the family. They're trying to keep it and make it look nice and pretty. So they have time, right? And with time, gives you the ability to look for grants. Now in Maryland, we use the Bay Restoration Fund to help offset the cost of these tank replacements for old homes on houses near riverways. So hopefully this homeowner is able to actually go part of that grant and not have to float the entire bill all by themselves. The tool that I'm gonna be using to measure the solids is gonna be in this black bag. We refer to this as a sludge judge. Basically what it is a pole with a ping pong ball in it. And you put it into the tank over there, you measure how full the tank is, it'll tell me how many solids are in there, and then we'll be able to see what's going on. Before we take that measurement though, we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna see if we can get the clean out, which should be right over there, dug up and open. So that way when we're done doing that measurement, we can attempt to try and run the camera back through the sewer line towards the house. All right, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna put this pole into the water, see how deep it is, and see if we can get, oh, that feels nice and thick. So we'll pull back up. And as we pull, we're able to see the amount of solids that are in the system. So it actually doesn't look too terribly bad, but it does have a low liquid level. So usually when I take these measurements, I try to get between 3 and 4 different measurements from all around the tank. And the reason why I want to do that is solids don't really all fall in the same spot. Sometimes you'll get a little bit higher, sometimes you'll get a bit lower. So our average between all of those three pools was about 14 inches. So what this tells me is that it's leaking. Now I talked to the construction company and it turns out there was actually a shed over top of this tank and that riser was actually covered with the ramp to the shed. Now nobody at all knows when this thing was last touched. So that leads towards its leaking tank. So now the next step is we need to look at the sewer line between the tank and the house. And the reason why is there's a driveway over top of it. With the depth of this tank, we want to make sure that we're not having any kind of collapses or any kind of damage into the sewer line. So the only way to check that is to look at it. So let's go ahead, grab the camera, take a peek inside of the pipes and see, hopefully, no issues. When it comes to these tanks, it's also important to think about the depth and the weight of the dirt. So each of these rings is gonna be about 1 foot. So we can see that we've got 4 rings stacked on top of each other. So that means that we've got 4 foot of dirt on the ceiling of the tank. Now, the lid on the actual tank is gonna be much higher than the inlet pipe and the outlet pipe. So that means that the sewer line is going to have roughly 5 feet of dirt on top of it. So we have our clean out right here. All right, little cast iron clean out. With a good old brass cap, we're gonna toss our camera back towards the house and hopefully we see no issues. Running the camera through the sewer line, we actually saw that it's cast iron. Didn't see any kind of obstructions, which is great. But it's old cast iron pipe and again, it's like 5 feet below the surface. So it's not gonna be a ideal situation, but when they go to replace the tank, it'd be a good idea to also consider replacing the sewer line. We usually recommend anytime you do a tank replacement, you already have the machine there, you really ought to just consider doing the sewer too, rather than connect a brand new tank to an old rotting sewer line and then a year or two, 6 months, whatever, have to go back and do it all over again. So now we get to play the fun game of put everything back in the ground. So with this particular tank, like I said, we have a leak, but we also have a dry well on the other side of the yard over in that little pile of bushes. The dry well is going to be the absorption system for this particular property. And the absorption system is designed to get rid of the water that you produce, right? So the tank is going to capture the solids. From there, you got to get rid of the water somehow. And that's where the pit comes into play. So we refer to it as a dry well. It could be called a seepage pit. Basically what it is just a big hole in the ground with dry stack cinder block and stone. And so what'll happen is you put 10 gallons into the tank, 10 gallons will then spill over out of the tank and into the pit. From there, all that water will basically work its way into the surrounding soil and filter out into the world, right? Nature's cycle begins and the water goes back out and everybody starts doing what they're supposed to do. With these systems, generally how we check to see if they're working is we do the hydraulic load, right? And that's where we put the water in. We already talked about that a little minute ago. So this one's working perfectly fine, draining exactly the way it's supposed to drain. But there's something really interesting with this particular one is that it's completely empty. So we don't have any records from the county. We know the house is from the 1800s, but because there's no water in the pit, we have a leaking tank. Now we can start to kind of put a little bit more stuff together to kind of prove that the tank is leaking. So we have low water level, high solids, unknown pumping time, underneath of a shed, very likely just has never been touched, and there's no water in the pit. So a house of this age should have something in the pit. Now, usually if you have nothing in the pit, that's because the tank's leaking. It's possible that you're in like the water table and it's just kind of working its way out, but not as common. We would ballpark this particular system to be somewhere in between 1960 to the mid 80s, just because of the design, the lids, and the access. A system from the 80s will still function, right? It'll still do what it's supposed to do. It's just they would have mid-seam tanks. So we know we have a leak. But the nice thing is rather than having to replace the entire thing, they can just put a new tank in and go from there. Now, with the river being nearby, it really kind of depends on whatever the county wants to do. So the whole reason we're here is because they're trying to fix up the house. And whenever you do that, at least in Baltimore County, the county is going to force you to have somebody come and take a look at the system and tell them what's on the site if they don't have anything on paper, on file, right? So this particular house is a really old one. It was probably done on paper. And, you know, maybe the house got renamed, the road got renamed, or something to that effect. And by that, I mean like the road name, street numbers, etc. And that piece of paper got lost. Happens all the time. And when that paper gets lost, the county has no idea what's on site. And before they let you build on that property or do any kind of major construction, they want to know what's there. So that way you don't just have a pipe from the house into the creek. Believe it or not, I see that so often on these old houses. You'll get a pipe just right into the river. And sometimes you'll have a filtering material, right? Like you'll have a tank in front of it and then it'll just be a straight pipe. But it happens, right? And so the county wants to make sure people aren't illegally getting rid of the sewage and contaminating the waterways and potentially hurting people, wildlife, etc. So that's why they get involved. It's not entirely common on newer homes, but these older houses, that's kind of how it goes. Hope that you guys found this interesting. I know we covered a lot of ground today. If you find this content enjoyable or if you gain any value from this, hit that like button, hit subscribe. I have more videos posted every day on the World of Well and Septic, and I look forward to talking to you guys tomorrow.